This is a P-class Ca2 plus ATPase pump present in the sarcoplasmic reticulum membrane or SR membrane of skeletal muscle cell. It constitutes more than 80% of the integral protein in the SR membranes. The molecular weight of P-class Ca2 plus ATPase pump is approximately equal to 110 kilodalton. The P-class Ca2 plus ATPase pump is a single polypeptide chain having four domains. The first domain is called as transmembrane domain, denoted as capital M. It anchors the protein to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The transmembrane domain has two Ca2 plus binding sites. The second domain is called as nucleotide binding domain, denoted as capital N. It is present in the cytosol. The nucleotide binding domain has an ATP binding site. The third domain is called as phosphorylation domain, denoted as capital P. It is also present in the cytosol. This phosphorylation domain has an aspartate amino acid which is denoted as ASP. The fourth domain is called as the actuator domain, denoted as capital A. It is also present in the cytosol. It connects two of the membrane spanning helices. In the E1 conformation, the two Ca2 plus binding sites located in the center of the membrane spanning domain faces the cytosol. In a contracted skeletal muscle cell, when the cytosolic calcium ion concentration is very low, affinity of two calcium binding sites for Ca2 plus ion is increased. As a result, two cytosolic calcium ions binds to the calcium binding sites in the transmembrane domain. Cytosolic ATP then binds to the ATP binding site present in the nucleotide binding domain. Cytosolic magnesium ion then binds to the ATP. The ATP then undergoes hydrolysis to produce ADP and a phosphate group. The phosphate group is transferred to a specific aspartate amino acid in the phosphorylation domain. The magnesium ion is then released to the cytosol. The ADP is also then released to the cytosol. A high energy aspartyl phosphate bond can be found in between the transferred phosphate group and aspartate amino acid in the phosphorylation domain. The P-class Ca2 plus ATPase pump then changes its conformation from E1 to E2 with two bound calcium ions. In this E2 conformation, a low energy aspartyl phosphate bond can be found between the transferred phosphate group and aspartate amino acid in the phosphorylation domain. In the E2 conformation, the two calcium ion binding sites are accessible to SR lumen. In the E2 conformation, the affinity of two calcium ion binding sites for calcium ions decreases. So the calcium ions spontaneously dissociates from the two calcium binding sites and enters to the SR lumen. As a result, the contracted skeletal muscle is get relaxed. The free energy or delta G0 of hydrolysis of aspartyl phosphate bond in the E1P is greater than the delta G0 of hydrolysis of aspartyl phosphate bond in E2P. This reduction in delta G0 of aspartyl phosphate bond powers the E1 to E2 conformational change. The aspartyl phosphate bond in the E2 conformation then undergoes hydrolysis to produce a PI or inorganic phosphate, which is released to the cytosol. Due to this dephosphorylation, E2 conformation is changed again to E1 conformation. Now this E1 conformation of P-class Ca2 plus ATPase pump is ready to transport two more calcium ions from the cytosol to the sarcoplasmic reticulum lumen. Please like, subscribe, and share.